So, for posterity's sake, and just so that we know what I'm doing, when you get here, I'm working on what's basically a papal bull, but it's for a hypothetical kind of fantasy universe, as far as I understand it. It's a client, it's a commission piece. They wrote the words, I do the writing. And so I have my parchment laid out. I actually have a second camera set up right here so that I can film myself working. Hopefully that works out. I have my coffee, and we're gonna get started. So I'm gonna start with, show you a little bit of practice from yesterday. So we're gonna work on a nicer version of that. And we'll go from there. We'll see how the idea of a live stream goes. I don't know how it works other than me directing people to my live stream. This probably won't do anything because I'm the only one here, but it'll get uploaded later and maybe people will watch it, so we'll see. I do have some followers, so we'll see. This is kind of impromptu at the last minute, just seeing, but I figured since I'm working, I can live stream, so we'll go with that. So right here, I've already mixed up my paint. This is vermilion in glare, and so it is going to be what I'm going to write all the letters with. Vermilion, you have to stir pretty frequently while you're working with it, because it settles to the bottom because the pigment is mercury-based, and so it is very, very heavy. Also, fairly certain it's like a million degrees outside right now. Not yet. It's 10 o'clock in the morning, and I think we're up to about 85, almost 90 right now. It's supposed to peak at 101, I think. Feels like 115 due to the humidity. But what that means is, difference in humidity inside versus out there. It's very weird, which affects paint and ink and how all of that behaves. So Although not something I do very often. Actually not something I've done before. So normally when I'm writing with black and red colors, I'll do all of the black, leave space for the red, and then move from there. There are some illumination kind of evidence examples that seem to indicate that multiple colors would be used and written with at once. And this text, the way they want it designed, the way everything is spaced out, it really makes more sense. To work with both colors at the same time. And so it's something that I'm trying, something I really haven't done before, just because I keep switching tools. I get in one mode and kind of work from there. and I think it's a me problem, kind of a mental completionist, want to complete one task and then move to the next. When I view the colors as separate. And so that may very well be what that is. And so I'm trying to work on working both today. So let's see what we can do. Hello! So, I'm new to live streaming, so I'm not actually sure how this quite works, but maybe I should put some music on. All messages are visible. Live chat. There we go. Alright, close. Hello, Geppetto! Although you said hi a while ago. I decided to set up a live stream, and then I'm recording myself, and
why not?
Yeah, the idea was, you know, if this does something, why not, but...
The kids wanted to stay home.
That's what I assumed.
but I just wanted you to know. So. And if you think
are they still talking about your dad?
They're done. I mean, they said they both have eaten breakfast. Do you need anything else in town?
No. There was something I thought of, but I don't remember where it was.
Refill? I'm headed to a bunch of places, so it'll take a little while, but also there's just more options if he wants stuff picked up, like Lowe's, all that stuff.
What do you mean at Lowe's?
Osprey.
No, they should have that at...
They might,
H-E-B.
But I didn't want to take the chance.
We'll just put it H-E-B first.
It's too hot to put groceries in the car, so I also have to go to Tractor Supply.
Well, but you do Tractor Supply, which is there, and then cut over to H-E-B.
Yeah, but it's just more efficient, like, since I'm already Tractor Supply, like...
Yeah, but I can just go to this Tractor Supply for Osprey if we have to. Like, I'm not worried. They probably have it at Tractor Supply, too, if
actually,
you're going
yeah,
out
I'll
first.
Tractor Supply because I'm not saying we have any double O's.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, but I do need to go to Target, too, for some other stuff.
Okay.
See you later,
see ya. See if we can do a better perspective of what I'm actually working on. Problem is, I'm gonna be in the way, but oh well. this is a kind of a new mode of operating for me, switching quills with different colors. Normally what I do is I'll do all of the black and come in and do the red. However, the style, just where the spacing is and how everything was designed, which is very important to the client, it allows me to play with kind of the multiple colors operating at one time, which is something that shows up in a couple of illuminated manuscripts, not very many though. So I thought it was worth experimenting with. So far, I find it slow and tedious, but it works. Really should have something under what I'm working on. Hello, Tabitha.
Hi.
What are you up to? Y'all want to play games?
That sounds good.
You finish with Grant?
Yeah. I turned up the notification and then it turned off.
For what?
The camera. Well, the screen turned off.
The camera is too hot.
What?
That's not cool.
That's crazy.
Too hot in the room. Since when is that a problem? Hold on.
Yeah, okay, that does feel kind of hot.
Yeah, that's crazy. Oh well.
Okay.
Can you turn that fan up? Click it twice, I guess. Yeah. It is warm in here, I'm not gonna lie. It's not, but apparently it is for the camera.
Yeah. I've never seen a camera do that. It's too hot. I'll just die.
You could bring that fan, that other fan, face it in here a little more. So that it blows in this corner. Face it this way more, turn it. Where it is good, but just turn it. There you go. We'll try that. I'm just trying to keep the noise down, but I guess we'll just pause with that camera for a bit. Who knew too hot was a problem?
Not me.
Yeah. Oh well. But yeah, Tabitha.
Uh-huh.
Y'all can, you guys can play some Zelda if you'd like.
Okay. That sounds good.
So, although probably hard to see, put in a window unit air conditioning because it's so hot here, and sliced up my index finger, which makes writing uncomfortable today. Just because I want to whine. We'll talk a little bit about some of the decisions that I've made. So typically with this hand, which is a Carolingian hand, all of the S's, including the terminal S's, those at the end of words, should be long S's. The reason we're doing this is because I need to stretch my hand, so I might as well talk while I'm stretching. So the choice was made in working with the client that he wanted this to be readable to modern eyes. Although very medieval looking and very historic looking, readability was one of his priorities. And so we focused on, the idea that kind of adjusting some things. So although I would love to put some of the elisions in here, I would love to put long S's for where all of the S's are, decided not to do that for the sake of modern readability. And I'll tell you that it's an interesting thing if I choose to make more historic lettering decisions, and they're not as readable, and it feels weird, I sell less prints of things, and people are less satisfied with it, because they want it to look medieval and to look historic, but they also want it to kind of, the letters to look the way they expect them to look, so, it's interesting. Although this is one of the few pieces that I've actually been commissioned to do in Latin, which I do enjoy getting to work in Latin.
Thank you.
Hold on, we're gonna switch music. To put things in perspective, we are about half done. Not quite. Cut the quill, clean up all the edges, and back to it. So it's interesting, it's this weird balance. It's not sure whether it's a quill problem, parchment problem, but sometimes when you have issues, it can be any of the above causing hairlines not to be as fine as you want. So sometimes you just have to go with it, because it's the parchment area, and you're not going to fix that sometimes. Thank you. Hold up. Thank you. Thank you for joining me, those of you that did.